Whenever I've done this challenge in the past, I've always had to rely on 3 stars to be able to clear the event in full, but it's been a while since I've done a no repeat challenge, in the time we got level 3 models and multiple new 4 stars. Let's see if we can make do without the 3 stars this time.
目標さえ達成できれば家庭は多少めちゃくちゃでも大丈夫だよね。
This stage spams a bunch of trash at the end, but it also has a drone. The drone is unusual for the first stage, but it's not a problem. It just means we need to bring some anti-air. So our best options are Arin, Wu Xiaohei, Frostleaf, plus some second operator, or something like Deep Cower. I don't want to spend 2 operators or Deep Cower, so I go with Arin here. We will find some other place to dump Frostleaf. Because I only do this challenge on repeat events, my brain starts forming a strategy of how to place operators, even if I don't really try. And according to that strategy, I focus on using operators I value less on easier stages. Even though Orin is a good operator, he isn't too useful on any later stage, so I'm fine with dumping him here. Break the Ice 2 has 2 gimmicks, Global Damage Snipers and the Frozen Tiles on the right. While I have operators who can solo this like Estelle, they're to be used in harder stages. If we left Scavenger alone, she would leak some trash and even die to the snipers later on, so we need some second operator. I go with Courier because I don't value Vanguards much in this run. Break the Ice 3 is the mob that introduces the casters, it just has a bunch of trash. Jessica is there to shoot the casters while protecting herself with her dodge and skill 2, and Vigna is there to take care of everything else. It's interesting to know that I'm actually using Vigna as one here. Because the dogs come so quickly and Vigna's fighting other enemies in the meantime, the attack cycle of S2 was too slow, and because she doesn't one-shot with it, it took a bit too long and she ended up leaking a dog. So I switched to S1, which worked better in this particular case, even though it has far lower DPS than S2. I tried to see if Quad can solo BI4, but there's no hope, she dies to even the dogs without any help from the Spider-Man. I'll save her for later. You may be surprised to use Pudding so early if you know she's one of the stronger 4 stars. The reason for that is that I actually skipped this map and only did it after I finished every other map. I ended up not using Pudding anywhere else, so she might as well come here. Matoimaru with this one can make this a 2 operator run, but I had a better use for Matoimaru. So Rope and Conviction took her place here. My first idea for BI5 was Quartz plus a medic. That works fine, but I wanted to use Quartz on some harder map. She is decent at dealing with mid-range trash. So I changed it to Dobermann plus Shao, which also worked fine, but then I needed Shao elsewhere, so finally it ended up being Dobermann plus Gummy, which also clears everything just fine. Dobermann is better than a normal sniper here, because if a Gummy is healing the sniper, the Spider-Man explosion will hit the sniper and probably cause a kill. But Dobermann has such high defense that the snipers can finish her off. For BI6 I use Durnar, Wu Xiaohei and Purestream. Durnar handles almost everything, there's a few enemies that need to be killed by Wu, and Purestream covers with her big range. Durnar ends up taking a lot of damage near the end, so Purestream is needed over Chestnut, even if they can both cover it. Perfumer can probably work too, but I'd rather save her for a harder map. Enemies leaking past Durnar looks a bit scary, but the wind pushes them back in her. I already know this from an old run I did with Arin and Jaya, 2 operators.
Alright ladies, let's keep it cool.
Okay.
BI7 is a great map on which I can dump both Quartz and Frostleaf. First I need to deploy Quartz after Gavio, this is because Gavio eventually have 0 defense, and I don't want snipers to prioritize her and split her healing between herself and Quartz. Second, Quartz will leak trash on the second shield bro, there's just not enough damage for all the trash plus 2 heavy enemies. So using the Vanguard Frostleaf solve both of these issues easily enough. You may be surprised I'm using Totter on this stage instead of EX8, considering how well he counters Jijin. However, being that I have no Totter model on Yen, it comes in a later event, I can't use him to tree up EX8 and free up an operator from the 4 operators I have planned for it. I also can't do BI8 in 2 operators with Deep Cover without that model, so tree up is as low as I can do for this map anyway. You may remember I posted a similar run with Totter's model. Without the model, there's not enough damage for Meteor, Acid Drop and Totter to kill Legion, so we switch to Mei. After a bit of messy ground, I found the exact timing I needed for Totter to kill Legion here. In the EX stages we fight the elite versions of enemies, which have significantly higher stats. And that makes the 3 archers here very dangerous, since they can hit past the defense of most ranged operators. The map itself is the biggest trash spam in the event. To deal with the archers, I deployed Myrtle and Roberta to kill one each, and then had Cutter guard the left lane. She has skill too, so she can help on the right side too. Once Myrtle and Roberta kill their archers, I retreat them so I can use them later, but not before giving Cutter a makeup kit. I'll need every bit of Cutter health to win. I deploy Bubble to block on the right side. I thought I could use her skill too, taunt to kill the archers, but no such luck. Their unique targeting is higher than Bubble's taunt, so they keep focusing on Cutter. Once Roberta is redeployed on the final archer, I start spamming makeup devices at Cutter. Myrtle is used to block trash on the right side as well. Cutter can solo her lane but needs careful skill 2 timing. The final 2 dog waves have 3 dogs and 4 dogs close together. I need to hit just one dog with skill 2 on the first wave, so I can use the other dogs to charge it back up for the final wave. That was much harder than I expected from EX1. EX2 is much simpler. Shirayuki and Mei can 2 op it. Mei has already been used and I have a better map in mind for Shirayuki, so I just stick Shou in there along with 2 snipers and win easily. EX3 has 2 lanes with Trash Spam and Spider-Man coming through, but the hole in the middle will take care of a ton of them on its own due to the constant winds. There are a few casters and 3 drones which forces some range damage. I originally had Mur in this run and used Motomaru S1 to keep her alive, but I lacked damage for the last wave, so I switched to Perfumer and used Motomaru S2 instead. Perfumer's healing isn't enough to outheal the damage Motomaru takes, and I'm counting on that for later. Clicks Row would have been better served by an anti-air sniper, but I used them all up already. However, Click works fine due to her S2 giving her extra range. She can help both lanes and deal with the drones because of it. The casters who pass by the bottom damage Motomaru enough for her model to proc, drastically increasing her attack speed. With this, we have enough damage for the final trash wave. The strategy here is a simple one. Set up so that Susuru has a lower target priority than Gravel and Matterhorn. Ethan has the lowest target priority by default, so that way he has plenty of time to DPS down the casters without worrying about any key operator being frozen or dying. If Matterhorn blocks 2 wolves at once, the winds can knock the wolves into the blue box when they blow to the left. We use Gravel to manage this. It took some time to figure out how to move Gravel around to avoid any leaks, but once I had that, Ethan stuttered everything with little issue. EX5 is a spawn camp map. The Spider-Man on the outer ring circle 3 times before going into the blue box, so they're not much of a concern except when the wind blows them into the inner part of the map. Pinecone was used here for her ability to instant kill stuff with S1 spams. There are certain enemies that the wind blows past Jackie, and without Pinecone they're annoying to deal with. She is facing up because we want some damage on the Spider-Man as well. Pin stack is great here because we can retreat the crab to let the Spider-Man into Pinecone's range. Jackie and Mur are bodies and can be replaced with any similar operator. Mur's healing isn't enough at the end, so we collapse and all the operators die, but this isn't really a problem because everything's already cleared up. This is the map I was saving Estelle for from the start. The enemy spam is really annoying. Utagia with model can kill both casters and the shield bros on the top herself, but we don't have the model on EN yet, so Earth Spirit is used to help. Gitano takes care of the AFK casters with her S2 and provides a little extra damage to help Estelle. Chestnut covers the minimal healing needed, since Estelle covers herself. This is a box map. I have ranged operators and there are no enemy snipers, so I win. It's probably a 2 operator with Pudding plus Shiryuki, if I ever bother to grind it out. And finally we get to EX8. It's a very similar strategy to what we did last year. I improved it slightly because the auto kept failing. We use Deep Cover and Umbreo to kill all the trash, mostly Deep Cover for that. Once Dagen Breacher spawns, we use the tentacles plus Jaya, and with Umbreo's help, we have enough damage to kill her. Jaya needs to be deployed multiple times to get her down, but because her dash range is so short, she keeps dashing back into Jaya and taking a bunch of damage. In the meantime, Umbreo takes care of the first Halberd dude with her S2. She has enough damage to kill him in one skill. Indigo and Deep Cover kill all the shield cards at the bottom. For the second Halberd dude, he was killed by Jaya. And finally, the second phase is all that's left. Umbreo and Indigo can attack outside of her silence range, and Jaya and Deep Cover can stall enough for the kill to happen.
Mudadama wa nashi, kanpeki.